Hello one and all, and welcome back to Let's Play Empyrion Galactic Survival with me, EkkiThump. We're starting off this session with a bit of ground clearance. We're going to get rid of this terrain that's sticking up through the floor here. And then we're going to finish off the, the northern tower. And then we're going to get down to some texturing. Oh, I've actually got a block missing there. We go. Get down to some texturing, and that'll be us done on skill on. Hopefully we can complete everything this session. It's mostly just this tower. Need to do a bit of a ramp. Well, I suppose two ramps really, to get up from the ground floor and finish off putting the stairs down. There's another bot missing there. Let's fill that space in. Good. Everything's still nice and bright. I think we're on the next version from the previous video. I really don't honestly keep very much track of which alpha I'm on, but we're now on 4.1, and I think the last video was 4.0.1. Yeah, I think that's everything. Let's have a quick run around to check. Yep, we're all nice and flat now. So let's try and get these elevators in position where we want them. So it's central there. It is that one, I think. Centralized that way, yeah. And that way, yeah. So, and two. These are actually a bit tricky to place. I should have just clicked dragged. That would have been easier. So that takes us up to the floor of this building. Is it the second floor that has... It can't be second floor. Oh yeah, it is. The second floor has the windows, doesn't it? Yeah, second floor has... Is that 5 tall? It looks like there's three slanted windows. Shit, I'm gonna... Oh no, I've got the sniper rifle, I can zoom in. So we've got 1, 2, 3 windows. So is this... Hang on, I'm going to have to go over and check. Is the second floor 5 blocks tall then? So you've got 3 windows, 6. It's 3 windows and then 3 walls. How tall is this meant to be? It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh yeah, okay. So the second floor is slightly taller than the first floor. We can accommodate that as long as we know. Hey, up. Fuck it. I'm gonna put these goddamn stairs down now. I'm sick of having to hop up this thing. So windows, slanted windows. I have to remember that's the multi-tool. These are practically fucking invisible. Wait, are they actually invisible? cannot place this block on base. Are there different window blocks now? Have I got 500 of the wrong kind of window block? Fuck. Right, window blocks. Yeah, they've divided the types out. What the fuck? Artificial? I'm really going to have to start looking into what's been added in these patches. What's this? Artificial mass block balances the centre of mass for improved flight and hover behaviour. And they've added wing block and LCD screens. Holy shit, I'm going to have to catch up on some of this stuff. I've been guilty of not paying too close attention to what's in the patch notes. Anyway, for now, we only really want at most about 100 of these. These might as well go into the vehicle parts box. Let's have a quick look at the vehicles we've got. Yeah, I want to see the centre of mass of this thing, not the Atwin itself. It's not going to show me. Oh, I know what this might be showing with the blue ball, is where the centre of thrust is. So I guess you want to get the two balls lined up properly. I mean, it's close. Well, it looks close. That looks about right to me. Maybe it's a bit back heavy. That's an interesting new mechanic if it's... if that's what it actually is. Let's have a look, how are we doing with those windows? Fuck, man. Oh, this is going to take a while. Alright, I've got my window blocks. I'm ready to resume construction. Shit, screen freeze. Let us get over there, wherever there is, over there somewhere. And get these windows down. 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah, we've got the right height. Actually, there needs to be another one on top, doesn't there? Because this needs to be the... There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then there's a floor here. And then it's the windows on top of that. Right, so windows. We need the slanted ones. There we go. Which way around? It's this way around. So the dark patch is on the outside. So three height of windows, and then three thin walls on top of that. So there are the windows. And We actually wanted narrow walls on the outside. Do we want narrow walls on the outside? Oh, let's just say we wanted narrow walls on the outside as well. Save us going back over there to check again. So we're done with windows, and as is typical for us, we made about twice as many as we actually need. 3, 4, 5, 6, and that one just pokes over the edge. So we've got another floor on here. So there's one more floor to go on, and this starts moving inwards almost immediately, doesn't it? Well, pretty much actually immediately. Yeah, immediately starts slanting inwards. That's looks like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up. So let's get this flipped over. There's a bottom and a top. Now we want to do the steep diagonal slope again. The roof, and we've got to get those spikes on. Or horns, rather. Drop it, flip it, drop it, and flip it. Drop it, and flip it. Drop it, flip it, stack it, and reverse it. And there we go. Oh, there's the balconies to put on as well, aren't there? I need oxygen. Yeah, so we went very simple with the balconies. It's just literally just a ramp, upturned ramp protruding from the slots. Need to get the little we need to get the geometry sorted inside. So it was all right in here, it's just up here where we wanted to smooth off these weird edges. and there, that one's got to go, and that one, there and there. Oh, hang on. That needs to be turned, doesn't it? That one does as well. I think you can rotate these blocks for free with the CNR tool, but I just don't want to run back and get it. That's all of those, and we need to smooth off the top, I think it was slope blocks up there. So that's all as it should be. We've got to do the slopes outside. I'm sure some of these corner pieces don't need to be here actually. Well, if we're going to copy the other side, I think it only came down to there. Yeah, that's right. That one. Bing, bing, bing. Boof, 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 boof. Okay, that's this tower complete, I think. So only other wood blocks I need to put down still are on the thing here where we want to make a little ramp up to this platform from down in the valley. Which should be relatively simple. Do we want a ramp or do we want more stairs? Stairs would probably look better here. It's kind of a steep drop, so we don't need the horizontal extension of a proper ramp. Here we go. I kind of want to put an entrance archway over here. Let's see what these new LCD screens actually do. Whether you can like program them to display a message or some such. Placeable. It's placeable on base and CB and such. Is it meant to be the other way around? Ah, yeah, you can. That's pretty neat. text wrapping's a bit weird. Let's make ourselves one. Let's make two actually. Chuck. Glass plate, steel plate, computer, iron. Make a couple of screens. I have a feeling we may need more stairs, so I'll get those cooking as well. And while we're here, I'll grab the colouring tools. So TNS and colour tools. we're going to need a generator. That'll do. Small generator for a base. And a base fuel tank. We'll put some hydro fuel in. Need lights. Let's have a look at some lights. We'll go with perhaps 30 round interior lights. Hopefully that'll be enough. Let's grab those screens and a few stairs while they're been made. So what sort of sizes can you do for these? Two by two blocks is the biggest. It's a bit disappointing, I would like bigger ones. Okay, well let's try a 1x2 is the biggest. These are slightly underwhelming. One there, and oh, we need power in the base, don't we, to actually see this. Let's whack a generator in somewhere. Should probably squeeze it in here somewhere. Cover that back up. Oh, we've lost the text on the things. Welcome to Skill on HQ. No overlords on this point. Large font. Skill on, no beyond. Those things need to be a little bit bigger. What? Can you have two lines of text even? Oh. Apparently if you press escape, it cancels your changes to the text. Yeah, you can barely fucking read that. Nope, it's got ourselves another screen freeze. It's nice that they've added them though. That was actually one thing I did say I wanted to see in the game. Because it was kind of difficult. Well, it was basically impossible to display text. So that's one of the new toys. Little LCD panels. I mean, they'll be alright in bases. I just want to be able to do kind of large external displays with them as well. Right, we're done with building. Let's take integrity mode off. Stairs. Well, we're not quite done with building. We've got to put some slants on the side of the stairs, but we're almost done with building. There we go, stairred to perfection. So last bit of building then, is to just panel off the sides of these stairs. They're here somewhere. There we are. Slip walls. Okay, and let's yeah, let's just do this. Just adds a little bit of texture to the outside. Alright, so that's the panels on the main stairs done. We need to slope block these edges. Okay, and that's the last block of wood I think we'll need to place. Let me run back, refill on oxygen, refill on food, and then we'll start with the texturing and the colouring. And the lighting, of course. So I think with this one, we're still going to stick with the old faithful, the marble. Oh god, there's an extra block needed here. Okay. That's the last block we're placing. Where's the colour gun? There it is. But we might see if we can go with a different shade of marble. What do you think? Black marble? Kind of obsidian sort of texture? That's horrible. That's no better. That's a bit too bright. It's not bad looking. It's just kind of a shade too light for what I want. Whereas that's a little bit too dark. Well, I think we stick with marble for the most part anyway. Black marble, obsidian tower. Yeah, let's do it. So we've got ourselves a white tower now, a white marble tower. I'm going to decide whether I'm going to do the towers different colours. So we're going to have one black and one white. This one I think might actually be the black one. But we're going to decide first of all, we're going to do the whole texturing, then we're going to go around and do all the colouring. And we need floors. Now this is going to be the black one. Let's see what sort of texture do we want on the floor outside. Probably want the large. Large squares. Okay. So that is going to be eventually a red floor outside. Now we need to figure out what we want to do inside. Because we can have this carpet, but I don't think we want carpet in here actually. What we want is not, do we want marble? Mostly because red marble's disgusting. Love these. These are actually, yeah, these are nice. Love these instead of the floor. And these, of course, are the marble blocks from outside. So I'll just do a single-sided retexture on these. Just on the inside part. And there should be a couple, yeah, there's a few blocks I need to do. Sorry, shit, my oxygen's gone red. Right, let's rush back to Atomint. No time for the stairs, cowabunga! Oh, how good was that? Okay, so crisis averted and just need to hook these. There we go, and we should have balconies left to do. These can actually be marble as well, so they look like they're made out of the same. So they look like they're kind of a piece with the tower, rather than looking bolted on. There we go. One tower, one staircase down. Let's go and do the same textures on the other one. And then we'll work out the colours. I'm thinking white and gold on that side. Alright then, I've been round the towers, I've hand coloured every block that needs to be coloured, and I've put down some lights. So let's go and take a look at what we've built. We've got the archway here, welcome to Skill on HQ, no overlords beyond this point as we've seen. We've got the black tower with red lights on the south side, and on the north side we've got a white tower with some orange lights. So let's go and have a quick look at the dark tower first. I must say I quite like the way the textures turned out. I'm not quite sure if it's a graphical upgrade or if it just for some reason looks good to me today, but these textures really do look quite special now. So we've got the lovely onyx tower there, and we'll hop up onto the second floor where we've got our view out onto the conquered base over there and the vast deserts and dried up salt seas of Skillon. And we've got the view over to the white tower there, and we can go up to the next floor and nip out onto the balcony. And from here we can see all around us, very commanding view of Skillon. So let's go and take a quick look at the other tower. Yep. So as we climb the steps, the orange lights start to pop in. And you can see, whereas the other side was very dark, this side is very bright. It's sort of inspired a little bit by the high heavens from Diablo 3, this white and gold or sort of white and bright orange. You see, it's very bright in here. Not quite satisfied with the shade of the floor, but it's better than the yellow. So this is the colour it shall stick with. And if we go up onto the dais, and we've got the lovely warm glow. We can look across at the Dark Tower once again. We've got the conquered base over there. And generally, once again, a very commanding view of the surroundings on Skillon. So that is us done with this planet. And we are ready to move on. Our next target is going to be Aestus, a lava planet. So probably once again not very hospitable. We've got Aestus and Aetis and Oscatoon. Oscatoon is an interesting one, but that's a while away yet. So let's get back down to our twin and get our coordinates programmed in. Oh, and yes, I am going to have to pop back to Acura and pick up the hover vehicles, which I shamefully left behind. So there we go. That is the Twin Towers of Skillon. And it's time for us to go. So let's put the thrusters on. Get ourselves into space. And we'll just go and take a sneaky look at the next planet before we move on to the actual conquest of it next time around. Okay, Aestus locked in. We need to get a bit of clearance. Is it on the outside of the sky? It does look a very nasty little planet, doesn't it? Okay. 109, we should be ready. Here we go. My god. That is a very fearsome looking place. Let's see if we can navigate the asteroid belt. I'm not quite sure how well the capital ship would take it if you fly it into an asteroid, and I'm hoping I won't have to find out. Alright, great success. Transition complete. Hold on. Where's my stats screen? That's a relief. I couldn't see the markers for the Razor and the Striker. They are docked. They just don't have dots showing on the map. Wow. So hey, do you wonder if any plants grow here? Well, we're shooting at something. I think it's just that drone off in the distance. Oh, there was actually something on the ground there, I think. Right, well this should be stable, I guess. So let's turn the thrusters off. And let's just have a quick look at the surroundings. Jesus fucking Christ, is that ever bright. We'll find a better spot next time. For now we're just going to have a look at what Aestus looks like. Is there anything that's going to instantly kill us out here? No, I can see blue crystal, which is always nice. Two blue crystals in one. I thought it was a bit bigger. Let's try and stay within range of the guns. So effective range on pistol is 97, shotgun's 27, assault rifle 166. Huh. There are actually things growing on this barren Mordorscape. That's got to be rock, hasn't it? That's just rock. Well, I see drones. I don't see much else. There's a base over there. Sathium grows on this planet. Is that just a rock? Confetti moss. What does confetti moss do? Minus food plus stamina. There's a couple of plants like that. So what do we actually have on this planet in terms of resources? Erestrum, Sathium, Promethium and gold. Well, gold we don't care about at all. Promethium obviously very nice for fuel. Sathium we don't care about. We've got loads of, it's easier to get it from space than it is from mining on planets. Erestrum is an advanced material. I think that's the first time we've seen it as well. Okay. Well, we'll have to see what kind of mischief we can get up to in here next time. For now, this has been Let's Play Empyrion Galactic Survival, and I've been EkkiThump. Hope you've enjoyed it. Like and subscribe if you'd like to see more gameplay of this game, and I will see you next time.